So good morning, students. Let us continue with our revision for today. And before sharing the screen, and let's see, we'll do some grammar exercises. I have a few extracts with you all. Let's discuss those extracts. Okay, poetry extracts we had done yesterday. Which poem we had discussed? Dust of Snow we had done. Yes. And Fire and Ice also we had discussed. So what about Tiger in the Zoo? Yes, so who is the poet of Tiger in the Zoo? Leslie Norris. And what is the main idea here in this poem? What is it about? Is it about freedom or it's about captivity? What is the main idea which is discussed here? Yes, it is both. It is about confinement. It's about captivity as well as in freedom. Okay. And yes, so is the tiger in the same place or in two different places in this poem? Naturally, two different places to depict ideas. So he is there once he's in the zoo, and then he is in the wild. And is, yes, he's showing his force, and he's showing his energy, and showing how strong he is. Okay, right? And that is the true face of the tiger. Do you think the tiger has adapted to the changed environment? Do you think man has taken away the real personality of the tiger? Can I get answers from you, please? Yes. So let's be a very lively class, like you are in real life. Tense, very energetic, very talkative. Or online is what, captivity for you? And offline is freedom for you? Is it? Right? So we are going to keep quiet when we are online. Is that? Yes, Shantanu. That's what he's saying. No, we're not. We're going to get answers also. So the tiger has changed according to the surroundings, according to his new environment. And yes, the tiger has adapted itself. And how is it shown? How is that adaptation shown? The tiger just ignores the visitors, right? And he's controlling his anger. He just walks around very quietly on his padded feet, and he is controlling his anger. He's very quiet. Otherwise, yes, the tiger has this very loud roar, and it is able to scare men and scare all the animals in the forest also away. But here, at this moment, at the time, the tiger has adapted itself. Okay, right? So when that the contrast has been shown, yes, the tiger is there. The tiger in the zoo, okay, quiet, angry, ignoring humans, longing for its freedom. And that small cage is enough, is not enough to contain the energy of the tiger, right? And in the wilderness, once again, it's freedom, and it is lurking in the shadows, waiting for the right time to pounce on the deer. Yes, and how does he wait for the deer? How does the tiger wait for the deer to come? He hides in the long grass. Where do the deer and other animals come? Where the tiger can prey them, where the tiger can attack on them? The water hole, okay, right? And then once again, the tiger is there in the zoo, and the tiger stares out at night. What is the tiger doing in the zoo, in the cage? Looking outside, looks at the stars. What do you think reminds the tiger of the stars? They remind the tiger of? Yes, the open space is freedom, and how he could move around under those brilliant stars. So his eyes are still there, having the desire, having that dream to be once again out in the open. Okay, right? So he wants to be free once again. He wants to be in the open. And that is where the tiger should be. But man is such that we have taken away the freedom of almost everyone so that we can be free. And yes, so we are paying the consequences of disturbing nature. We're paying the consequences of interfering in the lives of the wild animals. And of course, interfering in nature, right? And yes, what is the reality when he tells us the tiger is there standing at the edge of the forest? And the villages are there. So he is there, right? On one side is the village, on the other side is the forest. And the tiger stands there and growling and roaring and is baring his fangs. And when he bears his fangs, what are his fangs? his big teeth, the canines, right? And yes, those fangs, they're very important for the tiger, for survival, for attacking the prey, for his food. And he's bearing the fangs and he's showing his anger. And of course, he's showing his dominance, he's showing his territory. And his warning man, that just stay away, stay out of my territory. What is the territory of the tiger? The forest. That is where he wants to be. And he does not want man to come there and interfere. This is the real life of the tiger. But man has changed everything for his selfish needs. Right? Yes. Because he thinks that, yeah, we need to put these animals in the zoo. We put them behind bars. And here, you know, this word behind bars. Who do we put behind bars? Criminals. Yes. So the police catches the criminals, puts them behind bars, gives them a sentence, right? Gives them punishment. And it seems here the tiger has been punished and he's there standing behind the bar and looking out of those bars which are there in his cage, and he's looking out at the people, is at the night, is looking at the stars, right? He's treated like a criminal, as if he's done something wrong. And yes, so the tiger has not done anything wrong at all. Okay, fine. Yes, so this is about the poem, The Tiger in the Zoo. It is about the life of the tiger and how the tiger should really live. So it's a contrast between being captive and being free. Okay, now here, look at this stanza or this extract that we have. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass, near the water hole where plump deer pass. So we've read this extract many, many times. Once again, which poem is it from? Tiger in the Zoo. Who is the poet? Leslie Norris. He is who over here? Who is he in these lines? He should be lurking in shadow. Who should be lurking in shadow? The tiger. Lurking is hiding. Right? And yes, so there was this extract also here in your exam. What does lurking mean? He's waiting in the shadows. He's hiding in the long grass, waiting for the opportunity. Right, to attack someone. Like we have, you know, we have criminals lurking in the dark corners or in the dark tunnels or in the dark areas at night. So what does that mean, lurking here? Yes, so they're waiting here, they're hiding, and they're waiting for the right moment or waiting for the opportune moment to pounce on their prey, to attack. Okay. Now, he hides in the long grass in order to, why does he hide in the grass? Is he scared? Is he hiding from someone? No, he's not hiding from someone. What is he waiting for? He's waiting for the moment to hunt his prey. So when the deer is there, right, drinking water, or when the deer is least bothered and is a little careless, and yes, so he thinks that right now the deer is quite near me and I can pounce on the deer, okay, hunting it. The idea that freedom is dear to everyone and is cherished more than anything else is conveyed in this poem. We agree with this completely, isn't it, right? And yes, so there are going to be other poems that you're going to read about which conveys this meaning of freedom. So everyone loves their freedom and everyone has the right to be free. So the rhyme scheme you will be able to identify, okay? Right. Now here, yes, so there's another extract which I am going to discuss here today, is that about your grammar skills. Let me see if I'm able to share the screen today. Yes, I am able to share the screen. So can we look at it here? So it is about, I said we'll do a little more narration here. We have to do this one. So can you start this passage here, boys? Amelia, what have you done with our shoes? Do you think I came here to take them off your feet? Right? Now, these are, what kind of sentences are they? Amelia, what have you done with our shoes? What kind of sentences are they? Dia, can you tell me? Interrogative sentences with a question mark at the end. What are we supposed to do? What are we supposed to do? Change it. Yes, what are the things you need to remember when you change your narration here of interrogative sentences? Yes, obviously we're going to remove the question mark. Yes. Then about the reported speech and the reporting verb, things you have to remember. What is it here? What is going to replace the question mark? Are we going to use that here? Are we going to use if, whether, or your, like, of course, what is here? So it will mean like that. Okay. Now see here, look at the blanks here. The boy stood puzzled and looked around for the shoes which were missing. This information is not given here. They asked Amelia. They asked Amelia. What did they ask Amelia? What have you done with our shoes? What? Yes. You would become? She. Yes, Jasleen. What? She had done with R will become their shoes. Okay, fine. So Jasleen knows the answer. Very nice. Do you think I came here to take them off your feet? Do you think I came here to take them off your feet? Yes, Jasleen, you can turn on your video, bache, right? And I'll ask you your question. You can give the answer then. Yes, Jasleen. Do you think I came here to take them off your feet? Amelia, pretending her ignorance about the shoes, asked the boys. So you can get questions directly, right? So you might not get a gap filling. You'll be asked to change them and then you have to find the right answer. Okay, right? Do you think I came here to take them off your feet? About the shoes? Ask the boys. What do you think? Because two blanks are there. Dash, that she had gone there. Dash. Do you think I came here to take them, the boys? If you think, they thought, right, that she had gone there to take them off their feet. Only your will change over here, isn't it? Right. Now, could I have a look at your paper for a moment? I just want to see the cricket result. So, woman, there are two parts. And remember, if two parts are there, you have to make changes in both the parts. Okay. So, both of the sentences, they need to be changed. A woman asked a stranger what? Could remain could? And it's interrogative. If she could have a look at your paper, his paper, for a moment. Okay. I just want to see the result, as she just wanted to see the cricket result. Nothing changing over here. Okay. I haven't quite finished with it. Once again, two parts. Could you wait for a moment? So what did the stranger tell her? That he had not. Yes. Quite finished with it. That is also there. And could you wait for a moment? And here it is. Yes, sir. And even if you say, right, if she could wait for a moment is also correct. And of course, and requested her to wait for a moment. That is also correct. Okay. Now, do you have a new book storybook, Reshma? No, I haven't, but I like storybooks. Mala has a lovely book with many beautiful pictures. Let us go and look at them. Do you have a new storybook, Reshma? Nitin asked Reshma if or whether she had a new storybook. Correct. Reshma told him that she hadn't. No, I haven't. But stated that she liked storybooks. Okay. Now, once again here, yes. So considering the pattern of the paper, what is it here? It is not that you will be asked for gap filling. You will be asked to pick up the correct option. So when you have to pick up the correct shop option, so you must be very, very aware of what are the things that you need to do and how to change things. Okay, right? So yeah, this is so easy for you, ma'am, that you've shared the answers also. So in case you missed out on what I'm saying, or you could not hear what I'm saying, then you can do that. He suggested that he let us go. Let us go. A suggestion, imperative. He suggested that they should go and look at them. Okay, so let us go. Suggestion, let would become what? Suggestion, right? How am I going to live on earth being so small and helpless? Child, God, I have chosen for you an angel. She will be waiting for you and take care of you. Please tell me my angel's name. It is not of no importance. You will call your angel mommy. How sweet. Right. How am I going to live on earth being so small and helpless? So whom's the child speaking to? The child is asking God. How am I going to live on earth? Right. A child asked God. Yes. How was he going to live on earth? Yes, being so small and helpless is given there. But you have to remember, you have to do the whole sentence. So read very, very carefully. Options here, very carefully. Okay? I have chosen for you an angel. So what did God tell? That he had chosen for him an angel who will be waiting for you and take care of you. Who would be waiting for him and take care of him? Two parts? Yes. So please tell my angel's name. Please request, right? So the child requested God to tell him his angel's name, right? And God told him that it was of no importance and he would call his angel mommy. So even if you do all the sentences here one by one, so you will be able to find out the answers. Now look at it here. Yes, sir. So here dialogue completion, I don't think so you will be doing. Okay, fine. Choose the correct. Jay said Vipul takes exercise daily. It's a statement here. Jay said that Vipul takes exercise daily. Absolutely right. He said man has two hands. He said that man had two hands. He said that man has two hands. He said that man have two hands. Man has two hands. He said that man has two hands. It's a truth. It's a, right? Gopi said, I have read all the stories. Gopi said that he had, yes, read all the stories. Yeah. I have read all the stories. He had read all the stories. The doctor said to the patient to give up smoking. So what is it? Yes. Give up smoking. The doctor said to the patient. And yes, so he's told him, he's given a advice, right? He's told him. Yeah. So we are using the doctor advise the patient to. So when we have our imperative sentences, yes, so how are we going to introduce the reported speech with your infinitive to? Okay, right? Of course, here you have what is it, right? With the reporting verb, what are you going to write? It's an advice, an order, command, a suggestion, a request. Yes, so, and then advise the patient to give up smoking. See, gave up smoking, give up smoking. Advice to the patient, no. Advise the patient to, right? So to would be before this, fine? Yes. Next is, Raga said, I have my own choice. Yes. So Raga said that he had his own choice. Remember that we change everything here when it comes to narration. Okay, so tenses change. Naturally, the pronouns change, the time changes, the position changes, right? So that he had his own choice. Janki says Ram is very wise. Yes? So says is there? Change would be there? Yes? Is it? So Janki? Yes, second one. So Janki says that Ram is very wise. Fine. So let me see your answers, right? You have given answers. Okay. Nishtha has joined the class. Very nice. Nishtha, please note down the attendance and send me. Okay. Very nice. Very good. Right. Fine. So next thing that we are going to do today is I'll write a few sentences on the blackboard once again, and you can see here. So write with all the things around here. Okay, right. So all of you here, I want you to go through this one letter here. Please note down the question. Let us write down the points here, what we can discuss over here. And accordingly, we can discuss the format and the content part. Okay, right. Now, so here you have to write a letter. What kind of letters are we doing? Letter to the editor and letter of complaints. Yes. Okay. Yes, tell me. Rishit, what letters are we doing? What is our syllabus this time? Who's going to tell me? Do you know what kind of letters you have to do? Now, if you have to write a letter, please write down the question. Yes, we have letter of complaint. Informal letters, Nishtha, do we have? Okay, right. So, yes, here we have our letter of complaint and we have letter to the editor, right? So to the editor, highlighting any issue, any problem that you have, or anything you would like to talk about, anything you would like to discuss. Now write a letter to the editor of a newspaper. You can write down. So I'll just write down the points here that we have to do, which is highlighting. Write a letter to the highlighting need for better facilities for pedestrians. Can you see this? Is the blackboard visible to you all? Yes? Is it visible? Okay. Yes. Okay. Now, all of you, just do one thing here. Can you just write down a few points that we can discuss here? You all know the format. I'm not discussing the format. Okay. You all know that. What comes first and what comes after, you all know that. Let us talk about here, because you would be given maybe some points and you should know what kind of content here. So first of all, yes. How is it? Letter or to the editor. What are the things that you would write here? That, first of all, your introduction, that I am a regular reader of your newspaper and it is a platform which highlights the issues which are there in the society. And through this medium or through this newspaper, I would like to bring to your notice, right, that yes, what is the letter about? The need for better facilities for pedestrians. Who are pedestrians? Who are pedestrians? Tell me. Who are pedestrians? Where do pedestrians which vehicle do they use? Yes, the pedestrians are the people who are on foot. Yes, so who are there walking on the streets? So, right. So, what should be done? Do you think people should walk on the streets? Should they go walking? I think that is the best solution that we can find. Considering so much of pollution is happening, we have consistently talking about traffic jams and things like that, right? So of course, it is very good, yes, to walk from one place to another if it is possible, but is it safe to walk? Is it safe for the people who are on the roads? So what can be done here? No, it is not safe. So how can we make them things safer for them? That is what this letter is about. Better facilities for pedestrians, okay? Yes, so it is a big inconvenience, right? So when the pedestrians are on the road, what about it? Yes, like if you look at the lights here, so there is, yes, when are the pedestrians supposed to cross the road? Which light the pedestrians would cross the road? The red light, when the traffic has stopped, yes. And is there a proper place for pedestrians to cross the road? Can they go anywhere in the middle of the road here and there zigzagging? There's a zebra crossing. Okay, so yes. What about the zebra crossings? Are they very prominent on the road? Are they there on the roads? Do we see them? No, we don't. So what is it that, yes, no, we don't see the zebra crossing. So zebra crossing should be there. And yes, so we have there on the zebra crossing also, and there's a sign also, right, of a person walking, that this is where they cross the road and the traffic has to stop over there. And it is at such a way where, you know, like it is not necessarily at a roundabout where the traffic is coming in all the different directions, where the traffic actually doesn't stop only. So when it is like you have your one-way road or your two-way road, whatever you call it, so from one direction, at least the traffic has stopped. So it is there for the pedestrian to cross over, right? Then, yes, what about where can they walk on the road? You have the shops on the road, the shopkeepers have encroached the space, and sometimes we have the people on the two-wheelers. They also come onto the side of the road. Where should the people walk? So one is, we will talk about a zebra crossing. Yes, the zebra crossing should be at prominent places, should be highlighted, and yes, of course, naturally painted, so that they are very clearly visible, and it should be, naturally, we should follow the rules and stop for the pedestrians to pass, isn't it? Right? Where should the pedestrians walk then? Where are they supposed to walk? Where should they walk? On the side of the road? Or there should be a pavement where they're supposed to walk. No vehicle should come over there, and people should not bring their scooters or their two-wheelers. Yes, so there should be pavement. There should be proper footpaths where the people should walk, right? Yes. And of course here, what about the drivers here? What do they do when they see people walking on the road? What do they do? Do they slow down the vehicles? Or they keep on honking their horns and they keep on blaming them. Arey, why are you walking here in the middle of the road? Right? And of course, yes. So naturally, yes, we should have facilities for the pedestrians. That is the people who are walking on the road. We should encourage more people to walk on the road because it is going to be safer and good for our surroundings and environment also. There need to be better facilities. That is, yes, the zebra crossings should be there. And for the pedestrians, there should be a footpath. Yes, so it should be clearly marked. That, right, so whether it is on the main, right, the roads there, or it is in the market, so there have to be places. And yes, so otherwise also in the marketplaces, what should be there? Should heavy traffic be allowed inside the marketplace? So we need more better parking facilities, right? So people, they should park the vehicles at a distance. So it will be easier for everyone, right? Yes, so there they can be on foot, right? So there should be certain areas that is there specifically where vehicles are not allowed and people can walk from one shop to the another and do their shopping in peace without bothering about, you know, yes, a cyclist hitting them or a two-wheeler coming and hitting them, isn't it? Right? Yes, and then of course, the most important point is the strict following of traffic rules. Okay, right. So it is time for your break also. So enjoy your break and we meet tomorrow. Okay. Yes. So we continue with